Hey guys, welcome back to Let's Play The Sims 3 Seasons Supernatural Edition. I'm Landros, and I'm up in map view. We're getting ready to go right back in. I'm actually getting Lucas up in just a minute. He's sleeping right now, and I'm going to send him over because he needs to get the shower taken care of because it looks like he's kind of doing a little bit, getting a little bit smelly. But anyway, it's still 4 o'clock in the morning, but I'm going to do something else for him real quick. I need to go into his lifetime rewards because he's got plenty, and I want to get him something real quick. I'm going to go in here and see, let's see. There's a few things that I wanted, but there's definitely one that I want to get, and I'm thinking it's all the way down. I know it's all the way down here. I think it's like around 20 or 25,000. I want him to get the Hardly Hungry. There it is. So he's got plenty of points for it, so we're going to get the Hardly Hungry lifetime reward for him. And he's going to go over, I've got him set up to go to the science lab to sell some of these insects that he's got in his inventory. And then I'm going to send him over to, in fact, let's go ahead and do that now. Send him over to Alistair's because he wants to get a couple of gems cut. And he also wants to put some things on consignment. So he's got a plan. And I've got a plan for Lucas here today. So looking at all of them, and I don't know, for some reason it does not show anything here, but he's completed his lifetime wish, and so has Samantha, and so has Ilea. Taylor's the only one who has not, besides Arthur. Of course, we haven't really worked with Arthur that much. Now, Taylor, it won't take much. He's already done the conversion of five different werewolves in town, but he needs to go hunting with the pack and make a lot of money. So he hasn't made any money with a pack yet. And so I am going to spend some time with him eventually, but not today. And you'll see why. So anyway, he's going to be the one that we're going to work on with that. And then, of course, with Arthur, Arthur doesn't have a whole lot to do. He's just got to actually make these plants bloom because I think he's already reached, if he hadn't reached level 10, he's pretty close. No, he's not. He's nowhere even near it. So yeah, Arthur's going to have to do a lot of gardening. So I've got some things to do with him, and we'll get there eventually. Now, before he actually goes, let me just double check. Do we have anything? Well, he could donate, but there's no mail as far as, we don't have to worry about anything as far as, bills or anything. So that was my main thing. Now, I got to get rid of this broom because he's not supposed to have a broom. And I do not want him running around town with a broom. He's a vampire. Come on. He needs a car. At least that's what I would expect for him. So let me look in his inventory. Also, there's something else I want to ask you guys about. Maybe you guys know how to get rid of it. Maybe you don't. But when I look down in here, he's got a whole bunch of these old bills right here. We got $4,000 for those, by the way. But all these old bills, and you can click on them all you want, but they don't seem to go anywhere. Hang on. Let me just turn to my testing cheats and see if we can delete them out that way. I don't know if you can or not. It'd be nice if you could, because I hate looking at them. Let's see. Now I'm clicking, and nothing happens. If I click... Nope, can't do anything. Can't get rid of them. I wish I could, but I can't. Anyway, if you guys know how to get rid of those stupid things, let me know, because I really have no idea. And I'd like to get them out of there. But unfortunately, I can't even get them moved over to anybody. I might be able to give them as a gift. I could try. I'll try with this person in just a minute. All right, go ahead and over here, Lucas. We're going to buy something. Actually, no. Before you do that, let's cut a stack of gems. Because you've got, I believe, a handful of these in here. Not a whole lot. And whatever you got, I'm not going to worry about the cut. I'm just going to cut them. I don't care what we get. Just do it emerald cut. And we'll just see what we got. And you're going to just keep doing this until we get finished with all these so we can set them up. I don't know how many you got in there. I couldn't tell you. Anyway, I love this thing. And I'm so glad they have it because otherwise you have to spend so much money on getting them cut. But this way, it didn't cost you anything. You can just come over here and do this all day long. As long as you got the gems to cut. All right, so yeah, we're going to go ahead and do an emerald cut. And I really ought to do some research and look up all the different cuts and see what's worth it. But for the gems, for this, it really doesn't matter. I mean, as long as you can take it over here and cut it for free, it doesn't really matter what cut you do. But I know the heart cut is usually like the highest, and you save that for your really expensive stuff. Now, I don't have any Tiberium, so I'm looking, but okay. All right, where did he get that? Oh, did he go? Oh, yeah, he did go over. But I don't think he actually got that out of, what did I just do? Did I cancel out of it? I did. Okay, I have no sense. I don't know what I'm doing. All right, so anyway, he's going to get these cut and get these over here so we can get everything in there. And I should have probably checked the mail to see if we had anything else, but it doesn't really matter. I'm basically leaving everybody... Oh, wait, he's got publicly disgraced. Yeah, because he was blowing things up. You know, come on, you gotta expect that. All right, Moonstone, let's go ahead and cut this thing up and do another emerald cut. What did he do? Oh, from biting a sim in public. That's what it was from. Okay, well, you know, it's gonna happen no matter what you do. All right, as far as his skills, his charisma is all the way up to 10. Oh, he's good. He's really good. He's going to have a lot of things taken care of. It's going to make it really easy to make friends and whatnot, so nice. All right, last thing to cut, and it'll be this one right here. Let's go ahead and do an oval cut since it's new. And then I'm going to go ahead and make sure he gets these over here. And Bonehilda just got her gardening up to level 6. All right, girl, you've just been killing it over there. Okay. We got some money for those insects, which is good. I'm just trying to clear out his inventory. And I could go over here and get this thing taken care of, but I really don't think I'm going to have to because, you know, it's not that big of a deal. When we get done, we're going to actually do a charming introduction to this guy, and we're going to be friends with him instantly. And then my goal is... I like the new university music, by the way. My goal is to actually go ahead and try to get rid of those bills. And so we'll try to gift him a bill. Probably won't be able to do it, but, you know, if I can gift a $200,000 car, I should be able to gift a stupid bill. All right, whatever we got, let's just get rid of it, including the things that he invented. I'm just going to get rid of all this stuff, these little piles. And, yeah, you can use these things. You can use them for some of your elixirs and whatnot, but I don't really have to. Now, there's certain things I do want to keep in here, so I got to be careful I don't sell everything out. The Porcinis, I don't think I needed them, but I'm going to just leave them just in case. And those I definitely want. The honey, let's go ahead and get rid of it. I can get more because we have our own bees. Okay. The Vial of Bliss, do I really need those? I never use them. But you know what? He does get kind of lonely, so I'm going to leave that. And I'm keeping the Valerian Root. Plasma Fruit I'll keep. The Red Toadstools I don't think I need, but I'm going to keep them just in case. All right, get this one out of here. Get that one out. Plasma Fruit you're keeping. Wolf's Mane, yes. Okay, all right. That's going to be a little bit loud. Okay, Honey, let's get rid of that. Okay, guys, I am sorry. Hang on just a second. All right, sorry, guys. I had the music was getting too loud, and I couldn't get out of it because I wanted to get those things sold. Anyway, let's go ahead and see if we can do this, if we can become friends with this guy. Very good. Now, I want you to go ahead and, let's see, where's some more? Come on. You can't give him a gift? Well, ask him about his career, even like you don't know what he does. He's going to tell you, I work here, idiot. All right, go ahead. I just want to see if he can do it. If he can't, then that's all right. All right, so Samantha's over there just learning all kinds of things, and that's good for her. All right, let's see what he can do. I didn't even look at that first screen, so let me go ahead and just double check. Come on. Seriously? I can't give a gift? Dispel the rumors. All right. Yeah, we learned he's a consignment specialist. Like we didn't know. All right, there you go. Okay, one last thing. One last time. No, can't do it. I cannot give a gift to this guy. That just stinks. Stinks like you wouldn't believe. All right, well, he's become our best friend after just this brief conversation. I love the charisma skill. I really do. It's a pain in the you-know-what to actually get it to this point, but I really like it. All right, Lucas, I'm going to send you home. Now, the reason I was doing that, the reason I was trying to get his inventory cleaned up, which I think we did, for the most part, yeah, see, look at all those bills. I can't get rid of them. I don't know how to get rid of them, and it really aggravates me. Now, the scrap I want to go ahead and do something with. I don't want to carry that with me as well. But he's got all these different elixirs and whatnot, and that's good. And I got to get him. We got to get rid of this broom. This is too much. So, tell you what. Let's go ahead and get him over there real quick. Let's see. Where's my car? He's got the car. Not that one. It's supposed to have that big black car, which I think is... No. Did you guys put it out here? Yeah, this is his... Make that his preferred vehicle, and then we're going to put it in his inventory, so that way he won't be just doing that anymore. Okay. We're not doing this. We're not doing this. Arthur, be careful. He'll eat you. He will eat you. Okay, we're not doing this. We're really not doing any of that. But what I am going to do with Lucas, I decided that we are going to go over, and you're going to watch TV? That's fine. We are going to take a few of them to university. And what I decided to do is, the reason I'm going to do university is, yeah, it's a Supernatural LP. However, I've done pretty much everything I wanted to do in Moonlight Falls. We didn't do any of the careers, so I didn't do the fortune teller thing, which I kind of think is a waste. It's pointless. It's just a rabbit hole career. But there were a few things I didn't do with the witch yet, which is kind of because I didn't want her to die. I know you can do the transmutation or whatever it is, and you can actually end up killing her. You can turn her back into gold or whatnot. You can haunt, and we did that a couple of times. But for the most part, I didn't want to actually kill her off, so I tried to steer clear of those things. I also didn't do the jelly beans because I've had incidents with that already, and I didn't want them to die from that after it took so long to get them all skilled up. But what I wanted to do is actually focus in on each one and give them their own little time to shine. So we're going to take them over to university, but we're only going to take one at a time. So we're going to start with Lucas, and he's going to head over to university in just a minute. So let's go ahead and enroll, and let's see what he can get into. I want to look and see. I know he's got a lot of credits already. And this way, we get to still see what he can do as a vampire, and he can do it over there. And then when we come back, we'll take somebody else, and we'll just kind of go in waves. And then eventually, I'll bring two at a time, and then maybe the last semester, I'll bring everybody together, and it'll be something different. All right, so Lucas, you could actually enroll in business, and you've already got 18 credits if you want to do that. Yeah, I don't think so. Technology, you've already got 18. Science and medicine. See, look, he is doing well in just about anything. Not in fine arts. Fine arts, he needs more. Communications? Oh, communications would be the biggest struggle for him. So he'd have to actually do quite a bit. And for physical education, he's got 18. So of all of them, do I really want to do business? I don't really want to do business with him. I'm thinking, since he does the alchemy and he does all the other stuff, it's either going to be technology or science and medicine. And I think with I'm trying to think what my other LP, which one is doing what. Spencer's doing the science or the technology. Nobody's doing science and medicine. All right, so we're going to do that, and that way we can send him. Maybe he wants to be the vampire doctor. I don't know. All right, we're going to start him off with how many credits? I want to do two terms, so that'll give him 2 weeks over there, and he's already got 18 of 48, so do I really need to do, if I did this, well, I guess it would be fine. He'd be really right on target to actually finish up. Or should I just do one term and just do, I can't even think what I want to do. I could do just 1 week, but no, I'd rather have 2 weeks so we can actually enjoy it. All right, I'm going to send him over there. He's got 18 credits. We're going to head off towards science, and we're going to just do it. They got plenty of money. He's got plenty of financial aid. So, Lucas, you are on your way to college. All right, we just enrolled, and he got $100 for that. Say goodbye to the family. We are on our way. And it'll be fun. He can actually do quite a bit, which the rest of the family can't do. But what I figured, this is kind of fun because it extends this LP a little bit more for me, since they can't actually age up. He's immortal, so he's never going to age up. And the rest of them are going to actually age up, and they're all saying goodbye to him. So say goodbye to the family, because Lucas, you are on your way. You should have kissed your wife goodbye, but you know what? She's probably going to just go to the hot tub right as soon as you leave anyway, so she doesn't care. All right. And unfortunately, we never did get rid of your publicly disgraced thing, but that's okay. Now, I love Moonlight Falls, and I hate to leave it. It's something that I'm like, I enjoy playing in this town a lot, but this will be fun too. It'll actually give us a way to see university through the eyes of a vampire, and then through the eyes of the werewolf, witch, and the fairy. So I think it'll be fun. All right, guys, let me go ahead and let this load up, and I'll be back in just a second when we're arriving at university. All right, well, here we are arriving at university, and I'm really excited because actually I get to actually do this with one sim, and I can concentrate on one different degree, and maybe I'll figure out what I'm doing wrong in my other university LP, but it'll be kind of fun. All right, now we got a few choices. We could actually do the dorm, which I've been doing the dorm, but I'm thinking what we're going to do with Lucas is we're going to let Lucas be a part of the fraternity, and the fraternity house is right here. So I'm thinking that this will be good. Now, we could actually rent one of the houses because we got plenty of money. You look at our money, we are good. He could have his own place, but I think what we're going to do is we're going to do the fraternity for now, and each one of them are going to get to live somewhere free and somewhere different, but then the last semester they come back over for, then we can bring them all and let them actually rent a house. So you go ahead, Lucas, you're going to get into this dorm right here. You're going to have some frat brothers really quickly, and we're going to get you set up. And I got some ideas of what I want to do for him and get his dorm all set up. So I'm really looking forward to it. All right, let's go ahead and find out where he's at. Okay, now that we've arrived, we may want to take a minute and select the bed you want to claim and decorate your room. All right, don't forget to set the lock options on your door if you prefer to keep out visitors. Well, you know that's going to happen. All right, let's go ahead and pause everything so we can go ahead and figure out what we want. Now, if you haven't seen the frat house, of course, it's right here. Let's go ahead and roll this up. All right, anyway, it's trying to load up for me. But it's actually a really nice, pretty house. Pretty simple, actually, as far as a build. It's just a big rectangle. However, it's got the multiple stories. It's got two stories up above, and it does have a basement as well. It looks pretty much like the regular dorms anyway. However, we got this one here looking downstairs. He's got, you know, it's got the nice kitchen and everything. They do have the keg stand right here, of course, which is what you would find in every dorm, every frat house. So, I mean, you got to expect that. Out here in the back, it does have a nice little bar out here, but it also has the garage with the pool table and the weight bench and everything else. So I think that's pretty cool. Now he's got this parking lot, and first thing we're going to do when we get over here, I'm going to show you what we're going to have to do because I've already made this mistake. Okay, I think Lucas would really benefit from living downstairs in the basement. Then again, maybe not, but I kind of like the idea that he would have this one right here. He'd have this shower, and he's got his own little private way into it. So I'm thinking that this is going to be his room right here. Let's go ahead and set that as his room. And we're going to go ahead and turn around here, make sure we get the walls up. Let's see. Wrong button. All right, let's go ahead and pull these walls back up. And we're going to say that the only person that can come in here, lock it for everyone but myself. And the same thing here. You're going to lock this one for everybody but yourself. And if you really want to do this and have a private bathroom, do it right here as well. This way you can actually make sure that nobody uses this one. We don't have to worry about being interrupted for anything. Okay, now, one thing I do want to do is I want to go right into, let me get these walls back down. We're going to go right into build mode. And a couple of things I want to take care of first. This bed is out of here, even though we just set it. And that's okay. We're going to go over here into, let me find the Supernatural pack. Yeah, I could go with the university one, but I really wanted to go with Supernatural because I want the altar bed. Now, this is the vampire bed that came with Supernatural. And yeah, it's an expensive one, but he's going to get plenty of energy from that. This little chair is out of here. Okay, we're going to stick with Supernatural stuff because you know that's what we're kind of blending this expansion pack. And he's going to get his own little elixir stand or alchemy station. And let's see if I can find a way to put it in here and make it actually make sense. No, not really where I want it there. I think it's because there's something on the wall. So let me go ahead and take that off the wall real quick and put it over here. Yeah, that'll actually fit there. Now let me slide it all the way to the wall. Okay, and then we can move this back a little bit better. Okay, makes a little bit more sense that way. Okay, if there's anything else that I want from him, this would be the time to do it. Let's go ahead and take a look. Not really. I don't really see a whole lot that I really need. Because again, this is just for Lucas. It's not for the whole family. We're not worried about anybody else. We're just doing this for us. However, I am going to go ahead and bring him. Let's see. Does he have a guitar? I think he does. I don't know. Maybe he doesn't. He's not really going to need one. But I thought he might have something for fun. Anyway, it doesn't really matter. What I do want to do is go through the house. Oh, he needs a hamper. That's right. Since you've got the washer and dryer on the premises, you better make sure you got a hamper. Okay, bathroom, hamper, and this is a sad thing. We're going to have to put one in every one of these rooms. Now, he's got enough money that I'm going to make sure he has a nice one in his room. But as for the rest of them, you know they're going to just drop their clothes wherever, and they got to have somewhere to put them. So this poor guy, he's going to get the cheapo version. Let's see, upstairs. Let's see, what can we do up here? Let's just give everybody a cheap one. That way we don't have just piles of clothes everywhere. All right. And then over here in this room, these are all okay. Got to make sure I go out into the garage too, because that's where they have the workout equipment. And we'll just have piles and piles out there too. So anyway, you guys are all going to get one of these. I can't believe they didn't already put one out for these for the dorm. But that's all right. You know, it's not like we can't do this. Okay. Last one for this guy right here. Now, if you've watched my university LP, you probably know what's coming next. They got a lot of stuff in this inventory, but you know what? These stereos are gone, because what happens is they all come home and they just blare them, and it drives me nuts. Now, I think there's only that one up here that I can see. Let me turn these. It's a little easier to see it when it's dark at night. Kind of weird. All right, go downstairs, make sure, because they will actually turn these things on, and they'll all keep doing it. And I believe there's one right here. Let's see, is that one? I think it is. No, that's a light. All right, this, I think it is one, and I'm probably going to leave it. But there's another one down here, too. This one right here is going. I don't mind if they turn one on, but it's when they turn a bunch of them on at the same time. That's when it gets annoying. Yeah, it's the same thing over here. So I'll leave that one for now, and if it becomes an issue, then it's just going. Okay, does he have one back here? I don't think he does. All right, nope, nobody else does over here. Okay, going downstairs, one more layer, a level. Okay, another stereo, and I'll put them out if we need them for a party or whatnot, but I'm not going to deal with them in every room going off at all different hours of the day and the night. This is a little bit much. Okay, now if he was actually human, I would actually do something over here with a kitchen, because he's got a little kitchen over here. But since he's not human, it doesn't really make a whole lot of sense. But what I was thinking, and yeah, we're going to do this real quick. You'll see what I'm doing in just a second. All right, let's move this out of here, and we're going to go over, and I have not forgotten, I still have to go back up and pull out, whatchamacallit, the garage and get those done. I want to go into late night real quick. And with late night, you get your professional bars and your dive bar. I don't really know the difference, but I think one of them just get different foods and whatnot. Anyway, I'm going to take that dive bar, and I'm going to take a sample of this, and I'm going to go ahead and try to put it on this bar, and hopefully it'll turn to where it actually matches. And it's got to think about it, because it's trying to figure out, where are we putting all this stuff on this bar? And it takes a while. Come on through. Yeah, okay, we need to check all this stuff. We got a lot to do. All right, well, apparently you didn't want it to work, did you? Well, you try it again. All right. And the only other thing I want to do is I want to fix that one little bar right there, that one little part, which would be this part. Okay, that's good enough for me. Say yes to that, and then we want to grab, let's grab that stool. And we only need the one stool. I mean, all right, put that back wherever it was. Okay, I just want this stool right here. No, I want the stool. Come on. Work with me, please. Okay. All right, take that stool. This can actually go. And this one can go. All right, so now we got a professional bar, so he can come over here and he can learn how to use it. And since he's got the vampire trait, he can learn to do it really, really quickly. He doesn't really care about the refrigerator because of what his needs are pretty easy. Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and get out of this. Oh, wait, no, I'm not. I was about to forget. You guys were going to scream at me. All right, over here and this little place right out here. Let's go in here and get you guys, because you know when they come to work out, they're just going to drop their clothes everywhere. But let's just put this over here. That way they'll take care of it. And, of course, got that one right there, too. Don't know that I need to take it out of here, but I am, just because, I don't know. I just don't want to get the copyright little violations, which you can get every once in a while. All right, we're back in live mode, and before we go any further, let's go downstairs, make sure we set that as his bed again, because it should be his. I think it's already his, so that's good. All right, Lucas, we're going to turn you back on live mode, and you guys are good to go. All right, first of all, go talk to Jeffrey Dean. Go ahead and... No. You don't want to greet him rudely. I was about to make a big mistake. Go ahead and greet this guy. Go ahead and talk to him real quick. And you want to greet Ludo. You're going to make some friends really, really quickly. Sashko. All right, well, I thought you'd make friends faster than that, but I guess not. All right, can you go ahead and ask him about his day? And I thought you guys would, like, be instant friends, but I guess not. Not in university.
Munar.
I mean, he did get a big bump, but not what I thought. Go ahead and just talk to this guy real quick. Ask him about his alma mater. Let's see what we can do. Really? Well, I thought he'd be friends like instantly where he is back home, but I guess it's there's a little different, a different thing. So that's okay. Go ahead and quip a witticism. Why not? Now these guys are the rebels, so we can actually fix this. You're gonna throw this elixir at this guy real quick. Just go ahead and throw it at Ludo. You guys are going to be friends instantly. And the nice thing is he has that long-distance friend thing, so he won't lose friendship with him. Look at all the guys showing up now. And I think we may be the only vampire, because we're the only one sparkle. Oh, no. We sparkle because of our... you didn't throw it at him? All right, well, that's fine. Go ahead and start talking to people. To be honest with you, I was thinking that he was gonna actually get friends with them instantly, but apparently not. Apparently, that's just not gonna happen. Oh yeah, see now it works. That is too weird. All right, so I should have waited on the rest of them. Go ahead and chat. Ask about the book. Okay. Ask him about his alma mater, and we should make friends with everybody pretty quick. And that's gonna give us. It should give us some status with these people eventually, you would think. I mean, we haven't done anything with them, but we have actually made friends with them. All right, well, take your time. We're going to end up going over to the meet and greet pretty quick anyway. All right. Yeah, they didn't make friends with you. That's kind of weird. All right, who's this guy? All right, see, we're already friends with him. Is that him? All right, go talk to Ben. Ask him about his day. All right, ask him about his day. Make your friends. All right, they're just taking their time. They're driving me nuts. Now, it doesn't take long, and then, of course, we're going to get this meet and greet thing that we're all going to have to leave. But I don't know if everybody leaves, but at least some of us will. And who's this guy? Kyle? Kyle Shalom. We're going to ask him about his day. Don't miss anybody. Try not to. So, Lucas, you're already making a lot of friends already. That didn't take long at all. Oh, okay. So, we got some of the tourists from China that are over here. And these are your frat brothers, I'm assuming. No, university student. Okay. Well, what's that mean? University student, roommate, okay. All right, did you talk to this guy? Yeah, I think you did. All right. And go ahead and do the keg thing here. Do a keg stand with Jeffrey Dean. Of course, with you being a vampire is probably not your best thing in the world to do. But, you know, you can go ahead and do it. And see, now we got the lifetime wish thing, and it's showing up. It's really weird. Okay, you want a pillow fight with him? I thought they were getting rid of that. I don't think they got rid of it. I just think they supposedly lessened it to where you don't see it all the time. Invite Jonathan Dirk to visit? Well, we're not going home anytime soon, so don't worry about it. Do we have to go to the meet and greet? I think we do. No, we don't. All right, so go ahead. And Lucas has not gotten any, he hasn't gained any status yet, so I kind of thought you would get it once you became friends with him, but maybe it just takes a little while. Or maybe it doesn't count if it goes instantly like that, so I didn't think that would happen, but I could be wrong. Tell you what we're going to do is we're going to go out here, we're going to find a social status thing once he does keg stand. Go ahead and check for a social group job, and we'll see what we can get. I'm really hoping he can get into the rebels because, you know, he's a vampire. He should be a rebel. All right. Okay, here we go. Meet and greet time. So, got to go there first. We're the only ones that have, or the only one that has to go out of the house, I guess. Some of them may show up, but we're definitely going to go. Oh, wait, there's one thing I want to do. Hang on. And if you, I was going to make this mistake. Okay, if you have a garage like this at a dorm or at a frat house, you want to take this thing out of here. Because what will happen is you leave the car, and one of the other frat boys will take the car. And so then you're going to lose your car, especially if you forget to bring it back into your inventory. Anybody can use it once it's on the lot, even though you made it your preferred vehicle. So I just take it out. That way we have to park the car and keep it in our inventory, and we don't lose it. This way we don't have to ride bikes, which I cannot stand the bikes because they take way too long. But we're rich. We got money. We can do whatever we want. So we got over 300,000. So gotta love that. All right, now this should be good. We should start getting some other friends here and maybe make some more influence with these people. At least I would think. All right, go ahead and let's get a freebie. Let's go with the flying disc because you know I want that. Don't go upstairs, buddy. Go ahead and get a university poster. You can go ahead and get a kicky bag. I don't think you really care about the soda or the candy bar, but that's all right. All right, you want to buy a water slide? You could. We could do that and get you some points. I'm not going to do any of this, though. Jam with him? No. Let's go upstairs. And what I want to do real quick is... Let's see. Is there anything up here we can learn how to do anything? No. He's still working on things downstairs. All right. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually have him, instead of coming up here, which would have been fine, he's going to go over here and he's going to learn this thing. Research science real quick. Get yourself a little head start because, yeah, you are smart, but we're going to get you going a little bit faster. Now, with his stuff, what does he need to do? He needs to know science, gardening, fishing, all the things he doesn't really know. Okay, so that's fine. So here I thought he was going to have an easy time over here, but he doesn't really know fishing. He doesn't know gardening. Oh, man. All right, so here I was thinking we're going to have an easy time with you, Lucas, but no, you're going to have to work for your degree. That's all right. You can do it. But this will be good. So he's actually working on this. Don't have any idea of his grade yet. We have career history. Nothing at all. He has an A. He hasn't lost anything yet, so we're good. But we want to make sure we maintain it. So I'm going to try to do right by this guy because with my other ones, I have messed up royally. Now, he should have gotten in his inventory. He should have gotten something for his... He got the skeleton thing, so I guess he's got to work on that too. So we ought to actually, when he gets home, play around with that. He's got all of his invigorating elixirs and whatnot, so he's not going to have to sleep. And that way we can stay up tonight when it's late and where he learns skills twice as fast, and we can get ahead. And I'm assuming, let me go up here into map view while he's doing this. We've got a lake over here to learn how to fish. We've got this big thing over here we can go fish, which I haven't even gone to any of these places in my university LP. And let's see if there's anywhere else around town. Oh, yeah, we got this big lake up here, too. So, yeah, there's places for us to go explore. And being that he's a vampire and we can do this without having to sleep, we'll have a lot of fun out here tonight. So that's good. All right, I missed whatever that was. What did it say? Oh, Jeffrey Dean invited him to the party. That's at our house, so of course we're going to be going there. Yeah, we'll be there at 7:30. All right. That music is just a little bit too calm for me, but it's also a little bit too loud. And where's it coming from? I can't see it. Oh, it's right here. At least just lower it. I don't care if it's on, just lower it. Okay, Lucas, how are you doing? I know you've gotten up a little bit of this level. I don't think you've learned it that yet, though. But I could get you the brain-enhancing one. I think you can buy it, but I kind of like to wait and see if you get this as a gift. It'd be kind of nice if you did. But this is a great place for you to come and do some of your research because you're definitely going to need to use all this stuff. I didn't even look at your course and what you're having to do. When is your first class? In 21 hours. And what is your schedule like? Let's see. Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, you've got a 12 o'clock and a 4 o'clock. And then on Tuesday and Thursday, you have an 8 o'clock. All right, that's not too bad. So you're basically going pretty much very simple schedule. It's pretty easy. I think that's one of the easier ones. Or maybe it's all the same, but you know, he doesn't have to get up early except 2 days, and he only has one little thing to do, so that's good. And I do like the fact that, like I said, he's a vampire and he can learn quicker than everybody else at night. So, are you finished with that? Go ahead and research again. Oh, wait, you can actually already do a horticulture experiment? Oh, we're going to do that. Okay, because I haven't done that yet. Now, I'm assuming that he learned a skill. I don't think he did. I didn't see anything. But let me just double check. Now, of course, everybody else is all playing and doing their thing. But we're going to go to the frat party and we're going to have our own fun over there. Yeah, he does need to do something here. The nice thing is he's got a lot of friends and he can drink from his friends. He doesn't really have to worry about anything. And the fact that he's hardly hungry, this is not going to matter. It's not going to actually be a big thing. That's the one thing that's killing my family is that they're always tired and they're always hungry. So he's got an advantage over them. He's got several advantages. That's why I thought the Supernaturals would be really fun to take over to university because you can actually do it. It's not cheating. It's just, you know, that's their advantage. All right, you guys are working, or he's working really hard. That's pretty good. He could study, but I don't really want to study. I am going to have him do the blog and all that. He is going to work on a little bit. Might as well try to get into all the different social groups if he can. All he has to do really is just go over and I guess he could have gone and played sports. So you know what? Tell you what, we're not going to do this. We're going to stop real quick here. And I want you to go over here and just play a sport real quick. And that ought to get you into play football. That ought to get you into the jock group real quick. And then as far as the rebels, I think if you go get a street art kit and you go paint something somewhere, that might get you in the group as well. And then that way, when you're making friends, it should actually help. But I don't know. I probably messed you up. But there's a lot of people in this town. We can fix what we've already done. All right. I love having a car instead of a bike. So that's definitely something I may have to think about when I bring my family back. I may have to buy them cars, and that way it makes it easier. All right. I hate this umbrella thing. I ought to get rid of it. In fact, as soon as he goes in, I'm probably going to get rid of it. I mean, he never really needs it since he doesn't have to worry about the sun anymore. All right, put that thing down. Get rid of it. Come on. All right, when that thing goes in here, it is mine and it is gone. Maybe not. He's like, no, I know what you're going to do. I'm going to keep it. All right, fine. Oh, no, there it is. All right, yeah, we're out of here. All right, he's going to do this and he's going to get really nasty and smelly. Oh, he's losing his energy? That doesn't matter. Not for him. He can fix that real quick. He's going to go ahead and do this potent one once he gets out of here. All right, I'm going to speed him up real quick. I know my time just went up, but I'm not ready to stop yet. I'm ready to, because actually the loading screen took a long time. You have no idea how long that took. All right, now this should get him, I would assume, his jock cred. It should. He should get in that group. Wow, that energy is bad. So it's really different from everything else. Where you at, buddy? Drink that thing and show him how it's done. There you go. And not a problem at all. You go ahead and go ahead and go on home. Your party's probably already started. Okay. Yeah, I think the party's going. Yep, Jeffrey has a bonfire party starting soon. Lucas better not go, or better not miss it. So go ahead and go to the party. And we're going with you. So definitely an advantage right there. And did he get into that group? No. Why is he not getting into any groups? It really doesn't make sense to me that he didn't get into anything. Maybe I just did it completely wrong, or maybe he's not allowed to get into groups. All right, tell you what, while you're here, go ahead and just check for a social group job and let's see what we get. I mean, it's raining outside. You can't really do anything anyway. Let's see what you got. Okay, play with a flying disc on the university quad. All right, we can do that. And then check for a dare, because I think that's going to help you too. Perform a keg stand with a keg. All right, let's go do it. We can do that right now. Do it with, where's Jeffrey at? Come on, Jeffrey. We tried to do this with you earlier, and you just weren't going to do it with us. So now you have no choice. Get over here and do the keg stand. And be careful. This vampire, he will take you out. Come on, Jeffrey. Is that Jeffrey? Yeah. right, so Jeffrey, we got to get friends with you so we can, look, he's already at a 9, and we can't even get a point. That's not good. Although I'm assuming with that, that's actually helping us, at least I would think. And then we're going to talk to Jeffrey a little bit. Oh, stop it. We'll go ahead and greet. Yeah, that should be helping, but this guy's going to drive me nuts with this guitar. Did that get you in the group? No. Alright, friendly. Ask about the game. Friendly chat. Buddy, I want you to stop. That's why I hate when they play that guitar, because it's too loud. Alright, you're going to go ahead and... let's see. Compliment the party. And why are we not getting anything at all? We should be able to get... let's see. None of those. We should be getting some kind of things as far as his social group. Alright, tell you what. Go ahead and do funny. Show him a funny video. That'll help. Show a gross video. Yeah, I'm having to roll out of this thing because that guy's playing the stupid guitar and it's driving me nuts. Alright, show the cat video. Oh, start a fight at the party. Do I want to start a fight at the party? What do we get? Jock influence. Alright, you got it. We're going to start a fight. Who can we fight with? Do we know this guy? Yeah, do we know this guy? Yeah, we know everybody. That's a sad thing. Then we have to work on rebuilding the friendship. Alright, you're going to go ahead and intimidate him. Go ahead. Poor guy. He doesn't know what's coming. Calvin, we'll work on you as well. Alright, so good deal. We got into the rebel thing. Alright, at least we got something. I think, yeah, we got into the rebels. Alright, go ahead and... Lucas, come on. We still didn't make friends with Jeffrey, which I'm kind of surprised.
Masumu.
Yeah, Masumu. Calvin's just waiting. He has no idea. He has no idea what's coming his way. Oh, he's a friend. Alright. Alright, well, go pee and then you can come over and do this. I don't like having to do this because then it's going to mean we're going to have to work. Oh, you know, it doesn't matter. Go ahead because you can actually do the jar of friendship and you'll be best friends. So go ahead. Get in here and use your bathroom. Lucas, come on. Oh, I guess they locked the door from you? What's the deal with your social? It went down so low. Alright, well, come on. I need you to go ahead and get your bathroom taken care of. Go to your bathroom, at least. I mean, come on. Do this, and then you can go down here. Okay. Looks like the stereo is not staying. Let's see, is it this one? Alright, maybe it is. Go on down there and do that, and then you're going to work on Calvin again. Play Juice Pong. Yeah, we're going to do that. And then you're going to come back up here, and you are going to argue with him. I'm going to kill that guitar. Both of you. Both of you are going to lose your guitar if you don't stop it. You really are. Okay, you're going to scare him. You're going to... What else can you do mean? Oh, that's right in front of me. Insult him. Come on, Lucas, let me speed you up, because I've already passed my time. And this should be helping on your social. I mean, even though it's bad social. Oh, no, it probably goes against it. No, it doesn't. Alright, go ahead and just argue with him. Accuse of impropriety. Accuse of being a diva. Alright, go ahead. Intimidate the guy. Insult him. Let's see, what is this other one? Petty jab. Alright, go ahead. Alright, now you should be able to fight him. Fight. Alright. Slap him. How come you didn't get the fight one? You should have. Yell at, and then you're gonna get this wish taken care of. Did we already do it? No, we already did it. Alright, well, fine. I thought we had. I guess we already did it. Alright. You've been bad enough. Go ahead and throw this at him. You guys are going to be best of friends in just 2 seconds, so come on. Don't worry about it. There you go. Now you guys are good friends. And you know what? Let's see if your energy's good. Why don't you go ahead and drink from your best friend? I don't know what he's doing. Oh, he's going to capture the moment. All right. Yeah, you should have. When you just have a best friend, you should do something. Go ahead and do that. Oh, gosh. You've got to be kidding me with that. All right. For social networking, let's see. Why don't we go ahead and stream some video and go ahead and browse the web. I mean, if you're going to turn that thing on, you're going to make me... I'm going to have to go get rid of it. I know I am. All right. Well, I think we had a pretty decent first day here, and it's already 2 o'clock in the morning. But Lucas is in no danger of actually having to go to bed anytime soon because of his invigorating elixir. And in fact, he ought to be doing something with his work. Let's see what he can do. I'm going to go ahead and take out this... Go ahead and bone up on anatomy real quick. All right, you're going to finish that up. Come on. All right, he's streaming this video. That's fine. And, all right, did you not do it? Come on. Go find a place to do this. I mean, this is the perfect time of the day or time of the night for him to do it, so I figure we'll just let him come out here, do this, and we'll see if he gets the skill going pretty quick. I would assume, being a vampire, he can do it really fast. Yeah, he's got the little bats going around, so he's going to learn this quick. All right. And no danger of going to sleep anytime soon. So definitely worth taking a vampire that's actually at the top of his abilities over to university. So pretty good. All right, guys, I'm going to have to go ahead and end the episode here. Oh, Lucas is now a nerd. All right. So he got a little bit of nerd credit, and let's see, what else... Stop it! You're driving me nuts with that thing. He got nerd credit, and he did not get in with the jocks yet, which is kind of sad, but I kind of thought he would. Anyway, we may have to go in here and get rid of guitars and at least just give them sparingly because that's a bit much. So, had no idea. I knew the frat house drove me nuts because I tried it in one just little... I was trying a little mini game, and I knew the stereos were bad, but I forgot the guitars are just as bad. So, all right, guys. I'm going to end it here. When we come back, we'll be working on our first day of school, and I think he's going to do really well without any real effort because of his abilities. So thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.